Good evening, guys. What's going on? Thanks for joining me on my channel. I am Exploring with Jay. I've got a different type of video for you today. I've got a very sad video today. I don't like doing sad videos. I like the upbeat videos. I like to go be savage and go out and explore strange new places and boldly go where no one has gone before and that type of thing. But sometimes situations arise where you just happen to be in the right place at the right time, and you just have to pull your camera out. And I've got a very sad video for you today, so bear with it. Basically, the multi-million dollar home caught fire, and I happened to be at the right place at the right time, and I was able to film it live on Facebook, and I have pulled that video from Facebook, and I am now going to show it to you, for you. So, as sad as it is, enjoy. Maybe learn something from it. It's a pretty incredible video. Let's get to it. Alright guys, so this is how it starts. I am just picking my kid up from school. And we're in Lilydale Park, which is actually across the river valley from where this is going down. And I just happened to notice this big, black, thick plume of smoke coming up over the cathedral. The cathedral is this giant, beautiful Gothic church in downtown St. Paul. I looked at my wife and said, "Something's burning." She goes, "Well, let's go check it out." I'm down. I'm always down. So we go check it out. We get in there. We actually get in there before the fire crews get in there. One fire truck had shown up at this point, and they weren't even set up yet. So we got in there, we got upwind, excuse me, we got upwind away from the smoke as much as we could. I pulled out my phone and I started doing a live stream on Facebook. This is what you're seeing right now. Now, my phone battery was, of course, dead. So I actually had to switch my phone to my wife's phone. And unfortunately, her video footage isn't very good. So bear with it. I did fast forward it so you're not watching 17 minutes of straight garbage video, so, but, in a few minutes here, I'm gonna fast forward this and do it in a little bit faster speed. But this house is the fifth oldest house on what's called Cathedral Hill. Now, Cathedral Hill is a group of houses that back in the mid-1800s, early 1900s, if you were rich, if you were a railroad tycoon, a bank tycoon, a huge lawyer, basically, if you had money and you wanted to live in a big house, this is where you live. All these mansions are multi-million dollar mansions, and they're old as hell. So basically, yeah, this is the fifth oldest house in the area, and unfortunately, it burned down to the ground. So I'll let you enjoy this video, and it's about to start in rapid speed right about now. Nope, maybe not. Nope, this is the second video, that's right. This is another one from my phone. I'll be switching my wife's phone here in a minute, so. But yeah, I mean, it's very sad. A lot of these houses were bought up by contractors, and a lot of them are actually turned into sixplexes, fourplexes, duplexes type of thing now, so. It's multi-family homes now, but back in the day, single families used to live in these houses. So, but I filmed the firefighters doing their thing. At one point, you're gonna see three fire trucks battling this thing. Now, they did try and get inside, and they tried to battle it from inside, but there was concern that the floors were going to collapse, and they did. All three floors of the building ended up down on the first floor, and basically the whole house was gutted. Nobody was hurt. There was no injuries, even firefighters. No injuries. There was one cat, I believe, that perished in the house. Everybody got out just fine. So, and again, I did film this up until the homeowners came and started witnessing their multi-million dollar home being burnt down to the ground and nothing they could do about it. Things got very, very, very emotional, and out of respect for what they're about to deal with their property being absolutely destroyed, I decided to put the camera away and not film them in their infinite sorrow at this time. You know, I felt bad. I mean, everybody lost everything in this fire. And I do hope that the Red Cross helped them out. And I do hope that they were able to get back on their feet. It was October when this happened, so it was just a little bit before Halloween. But, yeah, very, very devastating fire. And a very historic house that went up in flames. So,
say hi to Elaine. She's watching.
I'll leave you to it with the rest of the video. One more thing that I feel like I want to add to is I want to give a really big shout out to the St. Paul Fire Department. You have to be one hell of a savage beast to go into a blazing fire like that to try and save people's homes and people's lives and stuff like that. I mean, you got to set all fear aside and just go in and get that job done. You know, and it takes a special kind of person to do this. So, I, Exploring with Jay, give the biggest shout out I can give to the St. Paul Fire Department. They did a hell of a job trying to save this historic house.